Today we're on the Pressy Lake Elephant Hill Fire, and this is the rehab site that CCR is currently doing. So today we're looking at the planters doing their job. It's kind of the final step of the process to be able to plant the area and see a new forest grow here. That's probably the best part of it all.
What we've done is we've removed the dead standing fir and just trying to accelerate getting a healthy forest back growing, reestablish some habitat and the hydrology of the site.
Land is so scarred up. We need trees to cover the area, so trees hold water too, eh? So if there's no trees in here, there's nothing that's gonna hold the water. Everything's gonna dry up.
Indigenous values in this type of projects are very important. We need to help Mother Nature. We need to get the land, you know, back up and growing, you know, producing resilient forest stands.
With us going in here now, planting trees, we create that new forest that holds moisture, it creates shade, and it actually in itself will help reduce the fire risk for this specific area.
It's a very physical job out here for sure.
Torrent Silviculture is our planting contractor, and they're actually a local contractor based out of Quesnel. And wherever possible, we try to work with local contractors in the area just to build those continual relationships. And they've actually been planting in the Caribou region and surrounding areas for 15 to 20 years. When we're reforesting these sites, we replace what we took off-site. So that's why we're focusing primarily Douglas fir with a component of lodgepole pine.
Yeah, stumps are the main thing you're looking for. If there's no stumps around, then you're looking for just the second biggest obstacle. Like the next thing we'll be looking for is probably like that log right there. It's the biggest thing around. And the fir really grow in like clusters, so you can put a couple nice and close to each other so they support each other through life. You also have to focus on your quality when you're tree planting. You're looking for like really prime soil and not too much debris. You kind of have to think throughout the day of how many trees you have in your land, and you're always thinking about where to go next usually. And usually the weather can be another big challenge for sure. A lot of trees throughout the day, like 4,000 to 5,000 trees. So you don't really want to keep count because then it just gets to you, you know, it's just a lot of trees.
This project is being funded by Natural Resources Canada and the 2 billion tree program.
I check quality to make sure it's planted well. I check to make sure it's planted on the right side of an obstacle to make sure it has as much protection from the sun as possible, and density. The planters are paid per tree, not per good tree. It's important for people like me to come in and check the trees, so they get paid for only planting the best trees. I put the pink markers down on every single planted tree, so when I get audited, the person who's auditing me knows what I've seen, and if I miss a tree, they can ding me for that. It's important to have accountability for me to be checking the planters and the people who are paying for the trees to be checking me, especially for the 2 billion trees program. It's important for the taxpayers to be getting the trees that they're paying for.
We believe that this trial, the Pressy Lake fiber utilization trial, was very successful in a lot of ways. We've learned a lot. This project was a total collaboration with a lot of different groups. We definitely want to move forward in phase two, and I think it'll be even a better trial. And, you know, we'd like to continue this in the future. I think this is a really great model for all other forest companies within BC who are dealing with devastating mega wildfires in their areas, and this can be replicated.